Yes. How your PN junction diode is different from the Zener diode? Is there any difference between these two semiconductor devices? And what is the difference? Yes, anyone?
Sir, in PN junction diode, the current is flowing in only forward direction, whereas in Zener diode, it can follow in both the directions.
If you see the reverse bias characteristic of PN junction, then in the reverse bias mode also current is flowing. If you increase the reverse voltage above the forward above the reverse breakover voltage, then also current is flowing in PN junction diode. Same thing happens in the Zener diode also. Okay, there is not a different thing. What is the main difference between Zener diode and PN junction diode? Yes, anyone? Biju, koi kaise? And why they use as a voltage regulator? See, generally, Zener diode is used in the electronic circuit to provide the constant voltage across the load. So you can see here in the circuit diagram, we have supply, we in series we connect the resistance, and then we connect the Zener diode across your load. RL is your load. Here we take resistive load. Across this load, we connect the Zener diode. So why we connect the Zener diode across the load? Because to provide the constant voltage across the load, and that's why it is called as a, and that's why we use the Zener diode as a voltage regulator device. So what is the characteristic of the Zener diode? Because of that, it acts as a voltage regulator. So let's understand this. So before that, you must understand the VI characteristic of the Zener diode. So in the VI characteristic, as we know, there are two mode. First in the forward bias mode, in the first quadrant, and in the third quadrant mode that we have, see, that is a reverse bias characteristic. So same like a PN junction diode, the forward bias characteristic of the Zener diode is same. There is nothing change in the forward bias characteristic, same as the diode characteristic. But in the reverse bias mode, when you apply the reverse voltage, and after particular reverse voltage, the diode, Zener diode, start conduction and it act as a switch. And voltage across the Zener diode that becomes constant. It means even if you apply the high reverse voltage across this Zener diode, but the voltage across the Zener diode that is remain constant. That's why we can say that the Zener diode is act as a voltage regulator IC. You can see here in the theory that the Zener diode continue to regulate the voltage until the diode current fall below the minimum value of the reverse breakdown region. So that it permits the current to flow in the forward direction, same like a normal diode. But in the reverse direction, the flow of current when the voltage is above a certain value, that value we call as a breakdown voltage, or we can call it as a Zener voltage. So when you apply the reverse voltage across the Zener diode, above the Zener voltage or above the breakdown voltage, then what will happen? Zener diode maintain the constant voltage across it. For any reverse voltage. Yes. So this is the characteristic. Otherwise, the Zener diode is similar to the diode characteristics. Its characteristic is similar to the your normal diode. So the purpose of the Zener diode is to regulate the voltage across the load, regardless of the variation of the input voltage. Means if you change the input voltage, but there is no change in the voltage across the Zener diode, it remains constant. So you can see here the Zener diode is connected across the load. So by the change in the input voltage, you can maintain the constant voltage across the load, because voltage across the Zener diode is remain constant. And that's why we connect the Zener diode in parallel with the load. As we know that in the parallel voltage is remain same. So whatever the voltage across Zener diode, same voltage is remain across the load. So for a variation in the supply voltage, you can maintain the constant voltage across the load if you connect the Zener diode across the load. And that's why we can say that the Zener diode is act as a voltage regulator. So to understand this operation of the Zener diode as a voltage regulator in detail, so let's see this video. In this you can understand it properly, how it acts as a voltage regulator. All of you can see this screen of this video? All of you?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So let's watch this video and understand the operation of Zener diode as a voltage regulator.
Diode as voltage regulator and find percentage line and load regulation. What is line and load regulation? Line regulation is the ability to maintain specified output voltage even with changes in the input line voltage. In this type of regulation, only input voltage changes, whereas load resistance is fixed. Output remains almost same as long as the input voltage is maintained above a certain minimum value.
So as you can see in the figure, a positive supply is connected at the cathode terminal of this Zener diode and negative terminal is connected with the anode. It means you apply the reverse voltage. Okay. So here supply voltage or input voltage given to the Zener diode, that is between cathode to anode. Clear? Positive at the cathode and negative at the anode.
Mathematically, it is equals to delta V naught divided by delta V in into 100. Where delta V naught is the change in output voltage for a particular change in input voltage delta V in. Next is the load regulation. It is the ability to maintain specified output voltage even in the presence of varying load. Here only input voltage is fixed and load resistance is varying. Output remains same as long as the load resistance is maintained above a minimum value.
So there are two ways you can use Zener diode as a voltage regulator. In one case, you vary the supply voltage and maintain the output voltage constant. Another way, you maintain the supply voltage constant but vary the load. So as we know that generally as we vary the load, the output voltage also varies. But in this case, if you use the Zener diode, the variation of the load also, you can maintain the constant output voltage. So that is another method which is called as a load regulation. And first one, that is a line regulation in which you vary the supply voltage and maintain the output voltage constant.
Mathematically, it is equals to VNL minus VFL divided by VFL into 100, where VNL is the null load resistor voltage. That is voltage when there is no load, and VFL is the full load resistor voltage. That is voltage when the load current is maximum. Next is how Zener diode regulates voltage. This is the circuit. Here we have a series resistor and a Zener and a load resistance are in parallel to each other. Here we apply the voltage source. This is the voltage across the Zener, VZ. It is also the output voltage. IS is equals to IZ plus IL. Now this is the IV curve of Zener diode. It is to be noted from the graph that in the reverse bias mode, after a particular voltage VZ, current increases sharply without any significant increase in the voltage. So this is the property that is being used here. So case one, line regulation, input voltage changes and load resistance is fixed in this case. Now suppose input voltage increases. Now because of that, series current IS will also increase, but no significant change in VZ. IL remain fixed, only IZ will increase. Hence, output voltage is fixed. Output voltage means voltage across zener or voltage across RL. Actually, when voltage increases, there is an increase in current also. The extra current will be taken up by the zener without any significant change in current across the load resistor, and the extra voltage will be dropped across series resistor RS. So next is case 2, that is of load regulation. Here input voltage is fixed and load resistance changes. Suppose RL increases, then load current decreases. So IZ adjusts itself such that IS, that is series current, remains the same. Now since IS is same, so voltage drop across RS, series resistor, will also be same. Hence, output voltage or VZ or the product of IL into RL is also fixed. So next, to implement it experimentally. So first,
so here you can see the graphically this experiment. In the next lecture, we will we'll perform this practical on hardware. But right now, you understand this practically by this graphically.
This is that of the line regulation. Here we need a power supply, series resistor, a combination of zener diode and load resistance RL of 1 kilo ohm. We also need a voltmeter to measure the voltage, but in this case we are going to use multimeter because it gives accurate values. So let's start. This is the series resistor RS of 100 ohm. And this is load resistance RL.
All of you know this, this is a breadboard. How this breadboard is used? All of you know this? But then I can just use a breadboard. Yes or no?
No, sir.
Okay. So first I give the explanation. Okay. What is this breadboard? So you can see in this breadboard, there are number of dots is given where you can connect your element. So you can see in the first two row and last two row, clear? This first row, all these dots that are internally connected, clear? There is internal connection is given by using the metallic strip. Internally, all these dots, which is given in this row, first row, that are internally connected, clear? Same way, second row, all the dots are internally connected. So that is a series connection. Same way for the last two rows. In this between, here you can see this first part here, this all these dots in which all the vertical elements are connected internally. Not horizontal dots are connected. Same like first and second row. Clear? First, second row, all the horizontal dots are connected. But in this lower part and this part, all vertical dots are connected internally. All the horizontal dots are not connected. Clear? So by this way, this breadboard is made. So if you made any electronic circuit, small electronic circuit, where required 2 or 3 resistor or capacitor, so you can make your circuit and check it is working properly or not by using this breadboard. Because by simple connecting your element in this dot, you can see that your device or your circuit is working properly or not. So you know that in the electronic circuit, in the PCB, that you need to require design first and then you require the soldering. Clear? But if you first identify that your circuit is working properly or not, so that you can use your this breadboard first to identify that your circuit is working is not properly or not. Then after you can make this circuit in your PCB. Clear? So that's why generally we use this breadboard for the simple small circuit, small power electronic circuit, to understand the operation of the circuit. Clear? So that's why here you can see that these two resistors are connected in series. The one dot is connected here another dot is connected in the series because vertical dots are connected internally. Clear? First of all, see this video and then after I will give you the idea about how it is connected.
Of 1 kilo ohm, zener is connected.
I repeat again.
Accurate values. So let's start. This is the series resistor RS of 100 ohm. And this is load resistance RL of 1 kilo ohm. Zener is connected in parallel to RL. Now we can start connecting. The positive terminal of the power supply is connected to one end of a series resistor RS. And P side of the zener is connected to negative terminal of the power supply. And the other side of the resistor is connected with N of the zener. Now multimeter needs to be connected in parallel with zener diode or load resistance. Now here we can directly connect multimeter leads with the connecting wires, but it's always better to use crocodile clips for better contacts.
All of you understand this connection? All of yes. You understand this connection? Okay.
So now our circuit is complete. So let's zoom it. Now this is connected to this, 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 and these. All these four are connected. This, this, and this. These three are also connected. Now since our circuit is complete, let's switch on the power and increase the input voltage to say 1 volt. Now rotate the multimeter knob to 20 volt DC range. So we can see the output as about 0.9.
So this meter gives the voltage across zener diode, or you can say the voltage across the load. Okay. And this is a source voltage. So we first vary the source voltage and see that what is the effect in the voltage across the voltage across the zener diode or voltage across the resistor.
Volts for 1 volt input. So we can increase the voltage and measure the.
So if you observe that once the voltage across the zener diode becomes 6.58, and still if you increase the source voltage, the voltage across the zener diode remains same. See again.
Output as about 0.9 volts for 1 volt input. So we can increase the voltage and measure the output voltage. So we have increased in this case to 12 volts, but you can also increase the voltage to some 15 or 20 volts. But make sure the current through the zener does not exceed its maximum value. The maximum current that can be passed through the zener can be checked from its data sheet. So now we have the data, so let's plot it. So this is the graph. You can see with increase in input voltage, output voltage increases linearly initially.
So as you can see that as you change the input voltage, output voltage also increase, but up to 6.63 volt. Okay. After that, if you increase the supply voltage, then the output voltage they remain constant. Clear? It means that regulate the voltage. Zener diode act as a voltage source. So that's why we operate zener diode as a voltage.
And thereafter, it started saturating, leading to voltage.
So here we perform the zener diode as a voltage regulator. So here we have source, adjustable voltage source is given 0 to 230 volt. So this voltage two terminal here plus and minus. So let's see the connection. Positive of your supply, connect this positive input terminal, and negative terminal of your supply connected here. Next, here in the series we have resistance R1, which is internally connected, so there is no requirement of connection. But here at the cathode side, we need to require the connection. So connect the cathode, Zener diode with the circuit. And then here we want to measure the voltage across the Zener diode. Clear? So these terminals are common. Clear? It is a cathode terminal. So we connect the positive of voltmeter here and negative of the voltmeter at the anode here. Clear? So this voltmeter measure the voltage across the Zener diode. Now we also want to measure the load current flowing into this load resistance RL. Yeah, this is a load resistance. So we connect the ammeter in series. So this terminal connect the positive of ammeter and negative of ammeter is connected here. This side. Yeah. So current is flowing into this ammeter, positive out of this negative, flowing into this load resistance RL and complete the closed path. Here I can again repeat this. This is our supply voltage, adjustable voltage source. We can vary the voltage between 0 to 20 volt. Positive of the supply connected here, the positive terminal here, and the negative terminal is connected here. And in series, resistance R1 is already connected internally. Then we connect the cathode of the Zener diode with the circuit by using this probe. And then we measure the voltage across the Zener diode by using this voltmeter. This yellow connected with the positive of a voltmeter, and this red one is connected with the anode of the voltmeter. Clear? So this is the voltage across the Zener diode. And in series, we connect the ammeter. So this probe connect the positive of ammeter and negative with this terminal of load resistance. So that measures the current flowing into this load resistance. Clear? So this is all about the connection of this Zener diode circuit as a voltage regulator. So let's start the practical. So first we measure the voltage, supply voltage through this multimeter. So positive terminal of source is connected with the positive here, and negative terminal of source is connected with this common terminal of this multimeter. Okay, so this measure the supply voltage. So here we vary this supply voltage by this probe. You can see here the variable voltage, and here in this voltmeter gives a voltage across the Zener diode, and this meter, ammeter, gives the current flowing into this RL. Yeah, so we measure the three parameters. First is supply voltage, voltage across Zener diode, this one, and current flowing into this load resistance through this ammeter. Yeah. So let's on this kit. Now you can see the supply voltage. Here I hold this value because it is vary. So supply voltage, initially I give this circuit to 0.4 volt. Yeah. Supply voltage Vs to this circuit. Now at this time you can see the voltage across the Zener diode is 0.6 volt. At the time the load current flowing into the resistance is 0.7 ampere. Yeah? Now let's vary this supply voltage and see the changes in the voltage across the Zener diode. So here I set this supply voltage to 3.1 volt. Let's hold this value, 3.1 supply voltage. Zener voltage 2.36, current is 2.3 ampere. Clear? It is 2.3 milliampere. Okay, it is a current is milliampere. Now, let's again increase the value of supply voltage. So now supply voltage is 4.90 volt, and you can see the voltage across Zener diode 3.7 and current is 4.1. Let's again vary the voltage, supply voltage. Now set to 6.5 volt. Now see the voltage across Zener diode 5.0 to something. Clear? It is vary. So you can write any reading 4.7 or 4.8. Clear? 4.8 volt across the Zener diode. Now current is 5.3 ampere. Clear? Now let's again vary the supply voltage. See here, I increase the supply voltage up to 9.2 volt. Clear? And you can see the voltage across Zener diode is also increasing. 6.75 and current is 7.6. Again increase. Voltage across Zener diode is 7.27 volt. Current is 8.2. Now you can observe this. Now as we increase the supply voltage, you can see that voltage across the Zener diode is almost remain constant. It will not vary so much. See here, I increase the voltage up to 12 volt, more than 12 volt. Clear? Now you can see the voltage across Zener diode is increasing, but it's very small amount. So it is almost remain constant after the 10 volt. Clear? That means after 10 volt, it is saturated. And voltage across the Zener diode is remain constant around 7.3 volt. Yes. See here again increase the supply voltage more than 12 volt and see the voltage across the Zener diode. Now it is more than 14 volt. You can see the voltage almost is remain same 7.3, 7.35 volt. Here. Now again increase supply voltage. 17 volt. But as you can see that there is no large change in the voltage across the Zener diode. So as you can see that after some supply voltage, your Zener diode is act as a voltage regulator because that maintain the constant voltage across its terminal. And you can see that Zener diode is connected across the load. So it means your load get the constant voltage this with respect to change in the supply voltage after some voltage. So now we can see that we reach the 20 volt, then your voltage across the Zener diode is also 7.5. So there is not large change after the 10 volt supply voltage to 20 volt. Very small amount of change in the voltage across the Zener diode from 7.3 volt to 7.5 volt only. Clear? So in this range, it is act as a voltage regulator circuit.